Hello, this is Mike King from Ethereal 3D. This is part two of a series where we're looking at using some buildings from Google's 3D warehouse, using them as presets, and creating a cityscape in Modo 401. So what we did in the first tutorial was we downloaded some objects from Google's 3D warehouse. I picked some buildings out of the Chicago collection. I've pulled those into Modo, we saved those. I showed you that in the first tutorial. So this tutorial we're going to use some of these and create a city scheme. So to start, we just need a basic setup for a plane. So I'm going to create a plane here that's a kilometer by kilometer, which is basically going to be our city. I'm going to give it about 20 segments by 20 segments, and that's going to give us some geometry to use for putting the buildings on. I'm just going to name this mesh that I've made city, and as you can see, simple mesh, that's what we'll put the city on. I'm just going to give that a material by pressing M as well. And we'll name that city floor or city ground, which we can apply a texture to later if we can see through the buildings. So now all we're going to do is bring in some buildings that we used from the first part of the series. So I'm going to bring up my preset palette where I had saved all those in a buildings area. And I'm just going to pick a few of these to simplify things, but I'm just going to double click these. And all that's going to do is it's going to load them in straight into the background at their position of wherever they are saved as in the preset. So just to clean up my list a little bit, I like to keep my textures together and the buildings together just so it's easy to work with. And we've got four buildings here, which we're going to use replicators to spread those around across the city. So what we need to do in order to do that is to create a group. And the groups allow us then to put a number of items into that. So I'm just going to name a group called buildings. There we are. And I'm going to bring up an item list and just simply drag those four buildings that we have into the buildings list. So now we've got, if I expand that out, the four buildings in that buildings list, and I can come back to my main view, and the next thing we're going to need is a replicator. So new item for the scene, replicator, and that sets it in the scene, and I need to set some of the parameters on that now. So the prototype is going to be the buildings, and that's going to allow it to use all of the objects in that building group. Is the city. So as soon as I've got that set, it starts adding all my replicators into my scene, which you can see here. So I want to add a little bit of variation to these. So I'm going to come down and set up a random scale on the X to be about 25%. I'm going to give it a little more variation on the height, 45, and 25% on Z. I don't require uniform scale because I like the buildings to actually vary a fair bit. Just to speed up my display resolution here in OpenGL, I'm going to leave this as a 10% display. So now, as you can see, each of those buildings is being replicated around the scene. Now, you don't need to show the original at 0, 0, because they're being replicated by the replicator into each of the positions. So the other thing we can set with that replicator is how is it placing them. Right now it's just set to align to surface. I'm going to use it as the polygons, and that's going to keep them centered in rows, which you typically see in blocks in cities. So it's going to make it look a little more realistic. So I'm just going to open up a quick render preview. You can see we've got a pretty nice layout here. You can obviously add as many buildings as you like. If you want to add variation on the rotation of the buildings, what we do here is just get one of the buildings, and what we'll do, gonna duplicate that, and then what I want to do is just grab that building, rotate it by 90 degrees, and grab another one, duplicate it, rotate it by 90 degrees, grab a third building, duplicate it, and we can spin it by 180 degrees. And what that's going to do is it's going to keep those in the replicators. So there's 7 items now because we duplicated it, or in the group, sorry, and now the replicator is going to use those at random. So it's going to find some of those rotated and some not. So that's how it's going to use them. So the next thing we want to do is set up our scene so that we have a little better lighting, camera position, whatnot. So I'm just going to reposition the camera a little bit. Just do it quick in the viewport here. Now I can jump over to my shader tree, and I'm going to turn a few things on, like global illumination, and I'm going to bring up the environment itself. Expand that out, and I want to set the directional light to use physical sun model. I'm going to set up the sun to be late in the afternoon. And we're going to just expand that out so now our light material looks pretty good at the moment. I'm going to jump back to my environment. Find the environment to be a little intense. I'm just going to turn that down. Then I'm going to give my directional light a little more intensity so that we get brighter sunlight with a little less global illumination from the surroundings. The other thing we can do on the environment material is instead of using gradient, we can use physically based daylight. So I'm going to change it to physically based daylight. And now basically everything's controlled by the directional light's physical properties here. So just expand that up. We can scroll through our day, basically get all the light to change with it. Go late at night, get a nice evening cast. So I want to get a late day so that I can really see some shadows on the buildings. And then I'm just going to position the camera so that I can really accentuate some of those shadows. Get a view that I like. Yeah, I like the backside best. Gives a little more, sees a little better variation, I think, from that position, without having enough buildings in here. I'm just going to lower the camera down a little. Look over the peaks of these. Maybe I'll zoom back a bit. We've got more buildings in view. Okay.